Hi there. It's 5 in the morning and it's travel day. I'm on my way to Agadir. I spent the night in this here Premier Inn because my flight is at 10 past 7 in the morning and getting here that early would have been a nightmare. So I got here yesterday afternoon, spent the night, had dinner at the hotel, and now I'm up bright and early to head just across the street to Gatwick Airport to get on an EasyJet flight over to Morocco. So I'll take you along, show you the sights, and just generally chill out. Let's go. So before we get going, let's have a quick look around my room here at the Premier Inn, London Gatwick North Terminal. It's a decent room. The hotel itself is pretty good as well. Particularly like the location of the hotel. It's just across the road from the terminal, so it's very convenient to go between the two. My main issue with the room is the Wi-Fi was a bit patchy, so I was watching YouTube videos and they would have to stop a lot of times to buffer as the Wi-Fi dipped. But the speed generally was fine. I had some food at the restaurant. I had a steak for dinner and some churros for dessert, and that was great. So you can definitely feed yourself on site at the hotel, no problem there. Of course, there's also all the food stuff at the airport if you really want to. Let's have a look at my window here. I did have a view of the airport. I wasn't at the very top of the hotel, but I was quite high up, so there is a decent view across the way to the airport. A little bit less to see at night here, less activity going on. But during the day, you can see down to the apron and you can see planes going around, so a nice view. Certainly in the room I was in. Yep, there's me in the mirror there. Let's go have a look at the bathroom. Oh, me in the mirror again. Every time I see a mirror, you know, gotta in these videos. So yes, if you're wondering here in the bathroom why there's a Coke bottle in my sink, it's because the room doesn't have any kind of refrigeration in it. For one night, obviously that's not a big deal, but if you were staying for longer, I would bear that in mind. I'm using cold water in the sink to chill the Coke instead of ice, because Premier Inn doesn't have ice machines. You can, I believe, ask at the bar if you want ice, and they'll give you a bucket of ice that way, but for the brief time I was going to be there, it didn't seem worth doing that, but just bear that in mind. If you do want ice, you're probably going to have to ask for it. The rest of the room, you've got your hairdryer, you've got plenty of storage around. Enough, I would say, for one night, which makes sense because it's an airport hotel, you know. Most people staying here are doing what I was doing, which was staying there for this one night just before the flight. If you have suitcases, they can go under the bed here. I think if they were big enough, they probably wouldn't go there, but if you're smaller ones, your carry-on suitcases, they would go under there fine if you needed more space. So let's get on the flight here. This was an EasyJet flight on an Airbus. And if you're wondering why the trip is called ATOL The Way to Agadir, by the way, basically, originally I was not going to be going to Agadir. When this trip was originally booked, I wasn't even going to Morocco, I was going to Tunisia. But I booked that trip with Thomas Cook, and those of you watching particularly from the UK are probably aware that they collapsed. So between the time when I booked the trip and when I was going to go on it, the company I booked with collapsed. But as my trip was ATOL protected, I did get my money back, and so I used what money I got to scramble to book a new trip, which is this trip to Agadir. So it became ATOL The Way to Agadir. Here we go, looking across at the really cool bridge across the taxiway at Gatwick. It's really impressive to look at. I always like looking at it. So. It's cool. Walking across a pedestrian bridge basically over a taxiway is cool. So anyway, we'll proceed to take off here. A new feature in this video, I've been using chapters recently, but I know they don't work on certain platforms, like I usually watch YouTube on TV. So I've put in these so occasionally on-screen little time codes where if something's going on that you might not be interested in watching, you can jump ahead to that time code And that will get you to the next part of the video if you're not into, say, this, which is the plane taking off. So it's a reasonable flight over to Agadir. Yeah, obviously this is an EasyJet flight, so we're talking no frills. You get a seat and, in my case, some luggage, and that was about it. But, you know, this flight is just about short enough that you don't miss a full-service airline doing it. It's, you know, it's something like 3 to 4 hours. So it's not too long. Obviously, you're going to want to bring something to occupy your time. Be that, you know, downloading some videos on your iPad or whatever, or a book or something. But it's not so long that you'll, you know, get discomfortable or anything like that. I had wanted, obviously, to do this trip with Thomas Cook, who have their own planes, which have IFEs, and I had booked meals on those planes, but that all went awry. So I was just making the best of the situation with this EasyJet flight. You get some nice views across Africa, as you're flying over. So, you know, if you just want to look at the window, there is stuff to see. But yeah, my plan was to use a slightly more upmarket airline than EasyJet, but that will scuppered. I do still want to do the full integrated package deal at some point, because, you know, with Love Holidays, who I did this with, everything, you know, they've just packaged together stuff that they've got from separate vendors, EasyJet, third-party vendors as well, handling transportation between the hotel and the airport on the, you know, the Agadir side, all that. Whereas with Thomas Cook, all that would have been, you know, them. They would handle that. They would have reps on site, that sort of thing. I still want that kind of thing, but for this trip, I just had to get something done, and for the price that I had. And it was much later, so, you know, higher end options were more expensive by that point, so, you know, I still want to do that, but it will have to be something I do in the future. The thing is, I got back from this trip, this was in February of 2020, so I got back and then immediately the world shut down, so that got put off quite a bit. So hopefully now that things might start to be opening up again, I'll be able to do that. But that plan has not come to fruition yet. I definitely didn't hear. This was fine for, you know, the money and how relatively last minute it was, but I still would prefer something more altogether. Travel situation, once we landed, was a little bit hectic, finding, you know, the right place to go and all that. So something a bit more directed and altogether would be good. But let's jump ahead now and let the plane land. And if you're not interested in seeing the full landing sequence again, there's the time code, or you can use the chapters if you're on a Square platform.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to welcome you to Agadir, but the local time has just gone 10 minutes to 1 o'clock. The cabin crew will soon leave their seat to perform safety-related duties. Please remain seated with your seatbelts fastened until the aircraft has come to a complete and final stop and the captain has switched off the seatbelt signs. Please take all of your personal belongings with you, check in the seat pockets underneath your seats and in the lockers. Take care when opening the lockers in case anything falls out. If you have any items that can be recycled, please place them on the seats at the front and the rear of the aircraft as you leave. Smoking is not permitted until you reach a designated smoking area. Electronic devices may now be used. Before you fly with us again, why not download the EasyJet app and this lets you have full control. It's never been easier to book flights, check in, download boarding passes and manage your trip. We'd like to thank you for flying with us today. We look forward to welcoming you on board again soon. Once again, we'd like to apologise for our late arrival and to thank you very much for your patience and understanding. Thank you and good afternoon.
All right, Agadir Al-Massira Airport. So this is the smallest airport I've ever been to. You can see from that panorama there are very few other planes around, and what planes there were around were sort of in the regional jets to private plane territory, so very small, not a lot of planes around. We'll jump ahead now, and this is me going into my room at the Caribbean Village Hotel, which is something called the Caribbean Village Agador Hotel. It doesn't seem to exist. Just inside the door is the toilet, which is, you know, just on its own, separated off from the shower room, which I believe is the style of the area. Past that is this storage you've got here, some shelves, you know, behind this curtain, just out of the way. I didn't wind up using that storage, but that's just because I didn't have that much stuff because it was just me. Here's the shower room with the sink. That's me waving at another mirror, as I always tend to do. Sink's fine, it's decent sized, and the water was acceptable, so that was good. Shower worked fine while I was there. I know sometimes, you know, these far-flung hotels, they don't, but yep, my shower was okay. That white round thing on the wall there is a dispenser for your shower gel, your body gel, lotion, or whatever. There's the bed. This is actually a double. It's two singles that are able to be detached from each other if you want. I just left them together as a double like that because it was just me. So there wasn't much point in separating them, but you can if you want. You've got a couple of chairs and a coffee table. That TV is incredible. It's a CRT. It's me waving at another mirror. I couldn't really get any decent pictures from it. So, you know, don't rely on watching television if you're going there. But, you know, there are nice views. Got this balcony with, the table and chair set. I was sitting out here a lot. Yeah, the TV, don't bother, just bring a laptop, bring an iPad, something. That's what I did. But it was fascinating to see one of those old CRT TVs in use. Here's the sort of the wardrobe where I was keeping all my shirts and stuff. Again, it was just me, so I didn't need all that much storage. Here's a look at some of the view from the hotel. You can see the famous writing up on the hills. In Arabic, that says God, Country, King, I believe. And you can see that from a lot of places in the hotel, quite frankly. This is up at the courtyard outside of my room, looking down at one of the swimming pools. There's three swimming pools at the hotel. And you can also see out here, all the way across to the sea. That's over there. The beach is just beyond those buildings. Looking slightly further away than it is in reality here. Just because, you know, you're high up and it's not that long a walk. I'll show you some of the walk down there in a bit, but you can see the sea from the rooms, from the hotel quite easily. It's not that far away. It's not on the beach, but it's very, very close. You only have to cross a road, basically, and then walk straight down onto the beach promenade. Here's some more views from my balcony. Not the most amazing views from this particular room, but you can see the sea. There it is. It's over there. And it was nice to sit out on that balcony and just, you know, gaze out towards the sea sometimes. You know, while I was doing a bit of reading or between watching things or whatever. And again, the hills are just beyond the building. There, peeking out around that little peak. There it is. You can see the writing again. And that is lit up at night, so basically any time of the day or night, you can see the hills. And it does look very cool, especially when it's lit up at night. Over this way, the view is not as good. It's just out towards some of the other hotels and a not particularly well-kept hill there, but you know. Here's, you know, definite proof that is the sea, because there's some boats. I was really, for some reason, very excited that I could see these boats going from all the way back here. But yeah, there they are. There it goes. There's one, and there's the other one. I like boats. I like, you know, transportation of all kinds. There's a bunch of palm trees around as well. They're really leading into the Caribbean Village theme with this hotel. Yep, there they go. There's the other ones. That was a bit faster. What can I say? I enjoyed seeing the boats. So zoomy. You can also see the birds flying around. A lot of birds around. We'll see some more later. Very different kind of birds. So stay tuned if you're into critters, because there's more critters to be found. So this is the courtyard at ground level. My room is up there, that top floor. This is the ground floor. Each set of rooms are arranged into these, you know, individual little buildings. This particular one has this central courtyard with the rooms arranged on three floors around it. And then out here into the pathway to the main hotel area. If we wander over this way, we can get a look at that swimming pool we were looking at earlier from the other side. Across the way there, straight ahead, is sort of the area where my room was. We're at the other side of the swimming pool now. Now we're down on ground level with it. You can see this is a fairly simple, small swimming pool. And here on the left, just coming into view now, that's the poolside bar. So you can sort of sit in those chairs or on these sun loungers. And you know, while away your time, and you can get drinks from that bar during the day, to sort of daylight hours, not quite early in the morning, but you know, anytime around from, you know, like close to lunchtime to sort of mid-afternoon type, you can just sit around and there's drinks close by, so all good there. So that was kind of the a swimming pool that I would sit by, you know, middle of the day, but you know, you could conceivably be there all day. I would just move elsewhere because drink service there wasn't quite round the clock, but it, you know, it's a nice place to be. Plenty of sun lounges there, and some, as you saw, some chairs at the tables. This is the sort of main garden area behind the lobby building. There's some more rooms in some of those buildings around about, some water features as you're seeing, and also along the sides of this area there are some like third-party vendors, shops selling, you know, local things, clothing, souvenirs, that sort of thing. This is inside the main lobby building. You have this sort of lounge area. In the evenings, behind me, or to the right now, there's a bar, and you know, so you can just chill out in here in the evening and get some drinks, some snacks going, and just hang out, play pool or whatever. Up here in these black sort of hooded things, these are phones, so if you need to call That's where you go, and then that's the lobby there. Back outside, this is some more of the grounds of the hotel around rooms. There's some sort of novel art around, like this pot that's apparently spilled a mosaic. And, you know, things like that. Here's another look down those gardens. That's straight down towards the lobby. And then, yeah, on either side here, vendors selling things like clothing, souvenirs, and, you know, some odds and ends like that. Now look at that fountain. A lot of water features around, which, you know, it's always nice. Keeps the place feeling a little bit lively and nice. Walking around now some of the back of the facilities, some more garden stuff you can see. A lot of lush greenery around, so generally a nice hotel to sort of wander around. Coming up ahead of us on the pathway are some of the sports facilities. So there's a bunch of sports facilities at the hotel. I think there's a basketball court there. I believe this is a badminton court. It could be a volleyball court. Someone will correct me, I'm sure, in the comments if it's not a badminton court. But yeah, there's the basketball court just there. And then here by the path is a mini golf course. So, you know, if you want to get your mini golf on, you can do that right there on the hotel grounds. There's some of these holes look quite simple. Some of them look diabolical. I didn't partake because I wasn't in a group, but if you were, I think that'd be quite fun. These little that white fenced off thing on a post, you'll see those around the resort. Those are basically places to put back drinks for the drink cups for them to be collected away and taken back if you've wandered away from the bar area or whatever with them. So here you can see more sports facilities. There's the clay court tennis court there. There's like three, I think, of those total. I could be wrong. But yeah, there's one of them. And I think there's two more up here, one there and one there. You're probably seeing signs saying beach. And yes, that is where we're going. So I'll show you the beach in a moment. Once we get past these tennis courts, we'll have a look in this one first. It's quite a quick walk, to be honest. This is really towards the very edge of the hotel. And now here we are. That fence there is the perimeter of the hotel down there. And then behind us is those tennis courts. The beach is just past those buildings there. So we're going to go down there and then through that little cut through. And then that takes you to the beach. There's the road you have to cross. That's literally it. Cross there, past that sort of... you can see the other side, and then if you walk down, you get to here. So there's the writing in the hills again, and then here's the beach. The hotel has a section of the beach roped off for private use, and there's also a bar on that part of the beach. I think it's in that little tent there. And so from there, you can still use your hotel wristband and get your free drinks whilst you lounge in a lounge chair on the beach instead of by the pool. Taking a quick wander back now, and we'll see a little bit of the route you have to take. So this is the little bridge across. What would normally, or in the past, would have been some kind of water feature, but obviously the fountains are off, so there's nothing there. And then you literally just cross that road, and you're back where we were before. So there's a little run between there and the beach itself, but it's only about, I'd say, a 30-second straight line walk past some buildings. It's not very interesting, so that's why I didn't film any of it, but yeah, it's very close by. All right, here we are back in the hotel. This is the other pool that's separate from the main area. I think this is called the family pool, and it has the little pizza snack bar beside it, but I didn't mind up using it very much because it's basically because it was the furthest one from my room. That's basically the reason. But yeah, it's down there as well if you want it. Up here is the drugstore, which is kind of like a drugstore in the US sense, I think, because it's basically a little convenience store. It sells, you know, I have got that bottle of Coke that you saw in my room in there. It sells souvenirs. I got an Agadir t-shirt in there and things like that. It also sold, for some reason, like Disney toys. So yeah, just a general store type thing. This area is called Oasis, and it's the main sort of leisure area of the hotel, the central part. The biggest pool is here. It's sort of big, and it's got a right angle in it and various sections. The main bar is there. And again, you really can see the writing on the hills from just about everywhere in the hotel. It's an iconic part of Agadir, so I think they may have deliberately made it so that there's a lot of sightlines to it, but this is quite a good one through the buildings there from the Oasis area. So you can see again, that pool is absolutely massive. So wandering up now, this is the route back up to where my room is. Up that way is the lobby area. This is the creperie, so you can get your crepes on, savory and sweet, I believe, throughout the day. And here is the restaurant Oasis, which is your main buffet dining for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. For some reason my footage from inside there is missing, but it's standard, you know, cheap hotel food. Here's Chocolate the Camel, who for a fee you can ride. And then here's some more of the critters around where I promised more birds. Well, there's peacocks. Peacocks everywhere. So here's one having a little wander. And in a moment you'll discover, not alone, there are several peacocks all around this area. And they just sort of wander freely and you can watch them going about their business. So while we watch some more peacocks, I'll just briefly touch on the food again. So the buffet lunch breakfast dinner combo is included with the all-inclusive package, as are, you know, drinks at the bars, the snack bar, that's is included as well, that sort of thing. The food in the buffet is fine for the price you're paying. I wouldn't go in expecting, you know, very high, you know, super high tier stuff, but if you're not too demanding for the money you paid, you'll be fed every day, so it's good for that. There's a broad range of stuff for various tastes. Some local stuff, you'll get, you know, sort of what you might call American fare, like, you know, there's chips every day. There's always going to be some kind of simple meat or fish or whatever. Sometimes there's barbecue, but yeah, it's fine. It's what it is. Also included is the entertainment. So we're now in the show building, and I'll show you some highlights of one of the evening's entertainments that you can go and watch. Optional, of course, you know, if you want to. I only did it once, but yeah, it was entertaining enough. And again, if you're not interested in seeing that, you can jump ahead to the next segment. We'll be right back. So that gives you a bit of an idea of the entertainment that was on offering. There was some stuff during the day as well, some similar sort of stuff outside, and then activities that they would do as well. I didn't do like full vlog daily stuff on this trip because mostly I was just, you know, sitting around. This was a lounge about lazy holiday rather than a doing stuff holiday, so there wasn't much of a variation day to day. It was mostly just me going to various places around the hotel or at the Vireo and just looking around, wandering, looking at things, reading, sitting, enjoying the sun or whatever. But, you know, that's what I was going for. So no need to draw this out, basically. So we're now at the end of the week and hopping back on the flight. Once again, as you can see, there are very few other planes around. Then what planes there are not really doing a whole lot. So we basically have the airport to ourselves. There were some other flights departing that day because there were plenty of people in the terminal. It's not a huge terminal, but there were a couple of other flights. But at this point, we were the only plane on the ground, basically, that had any significant capacity. So we basically had the place to ourselves. A very quick taxi to take off, and that was it. Back on our way. The airport doesn't have a huge amount of facilities, but there are, you know, enough shops to be getting stuff from if you need last minute souvenirs or, you know, flight essentials, and there are some places to get, you know, a bite to eat or whatever. I couldn't really find much that interested me per se, but that was okay because it meant I could try the EasyJet in-flight service, which I'll show you a bit of in a bit, but it's not exactly full service as you would expect from a budget airline. Anyway, let's see this takeoff sequence we got to incredibly quickly because the airport was not busy, and I'll check back in after.
Goodbye.
my quick summary thoughts on the hotel. For the money, not bad. It's not, you know, the most luxurious thing in the world. It's a budget hotel in a tourist spot. It was comfortable enough for the week I was there, on my own. I don't know how you would necessarily feel about it if you were in a bigger group, but it did me fine, and I was fed and watered for the time, so, you know, I was happy just in the sun. But if you've got more discerning tastes, you might want to pay a bit more. As you can see, flying away, you get some very nice views of the coastline here. And they just keep going. I had to cut down a lot of this because I filmed it for ages. Here is my in-flight service. I got a bacon roll, a can of Coke. It was fine. This plane being visible from our plane was much better. I was really excited about this. I don't think I've really seen much in the way of seeing another jet from your jets in my previous travels, so this was fun. But yeah, the bacon roll was fine for the money I paid for it. Definitely overpriced. But you know, that's budget airline travel, isn't it? So, again, a few hours later, here we are, landing back in Gatwick. So once again, if you want to see that, you can, and if not, there's the time code, or use the chapter function to skip ahead.
To London Gatwick, where the local time is 10 to 4. The cabin crew will shortly be leaving their seats.
So, thanks for joining me for ATOL The Way to Agadir. We'd all like to get back to doing stuff like this again, I'm sure, but we're not safe until everyone is safe. So if you can, please consider joining me in donating to vaccinate.org to help UNICEF bring vaccines to more people around the world. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please consider liking, sharing, and subscribing. And if you have any tips or questions, feel free to drop them below in the comment section and I will get back to you as soon as I can. Once again, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time for another video. Take care, everybody, and I'll see you then.
It's a three-pronged attack. Subliminal, liminal, and superliminal.
Superliminal?
I'll show you. Hey, you!
Like and subscribe.
Yeah, all right.
I'm in.